So, good morning, my dear kids. We are on chapter number 3, Earthquake in Assam, right? And in the previous lecture, we have started this chapter. And today, we are going to resume from where we have paused in the previous lecture, okay? So, let's recall them first and then after, move ahead, okay? So, till now, students, if you remember, we have seen in the chapter. So, we were actually talking about the earthquake that had taken place in Assam and Bengal in the year 1997. Now, that earthquake seemed so severe that even today the region of Brahmaputra River basin hasn't settled down yet, right? And grandmother always used to say that whenever the calamity comes, whenever this type of disaster comes, then grandfather is always having his bath, right? Because he loved taking bath. Then after, one more characteristic of the grandfather we have seen in the previous lecture, that he used to write the things. Unko likhna pasand tha, right? And his own letters, his memories made that earthquake recent and vivid. Usse lagta hai ki wo agar aap letters dekho, wo clippings dekho, to you feel ke haan ye earthquake abhi shayad aaya hoga. To itna recent aur vivid lagta tha. Because at that time the family was living in Shillong only. To puri family kahan pe rehti thi? Shillong mein hi rehti thi. So that's why. So now let's get started. आगे देखते हैं. So we have paused here in the previous lecture. So let's get started. So as I have mentioned, grandfather was in his bath, splashing about, and did not hear the first rumbling. And here the author, Ruskin Bond, keeps us reminding us the thing that grandfather is always having his bath even at the time of calamities, time of natural disaster. So, grandfather was in his bath, taking his bath, splashing about, splashing water around the aluminium tub, and actually he wasn't himself only, grandfather, right? So, he did not hear the first rumbling. The grandfather did not hear the first rumbling. First rumbling jo hua, unhone nahi suna. Rumbling means that is deep, loud sound. So he did not hear the first rumbling. But grandmother was in the garden. But grandmother was out in the garden. She was in the garden. Hanging out or taking in the washing, she could not, never remember which. So, she would be hanging out the clothes to dry or she would be washing the clothes that she would not remember now. Wo unko yaad nahi hai, and that exactly what was she doing. So, could never remember which. When suddenly the animals began making a hideous noise. Hideous noise means that is unpleasant noise. And at that time when grandmother was out in the garden, suddenly what happened? The animals began making a hideous noise. Unhone kuch unpleasant se sound banana shuru kar diya. A sure indication of a natural disaster, and that sound, that hideous sound, that was the sure intimation. Intimation means hint. That was the sure hint of natural disaster, that something is going to happen. Sure intimation of natural disaster. For animals sense the approach of an earthquake much more quickly than humans. So students always remember that more than humans, animals are able to sense if any natural disaster, if any natural calamity is going to take place, right? Humans se zyada animals ko wo sense hota hai कि अगर कुछ भी नेचुरल डिजास्टर आने वाला हो, कुछ भी ऐसा अर्थक्वेक या फ्लड या कुछ भी ऐसा होने वाला हो, नेचुरल कैलामिटी, नेचुरल डिजास्टर, तो उनको वो सेंस हो जाता है पहले से, एनिमल्स को, मोर देन दैट ह्यूमंस. द क्रोज ऑल टू क्वीन व्हीलिंग वाइल्डली ओवरहेड एंड कॉलिंग लाउडली. द चिकन्स फ्लैट इन सर्कल्स एज इफ दे वर बीइंग चेस्ड. Two dogs sitting in the veranda suddenly jumped up and ran out with their tails between their legs. So what about the animals? Let's see first about the birds. So what were they doing? Birds. So the crows all took wings. So all the crows flew away. All the crows flew away. Wheeling wildly, moving round and round overhead. Moving round and round. Overhead and cawing loudly, and cawing, that is the cry of a bird, especially crow, जो उनका cry करने का जो sound होता है वो cawing loudly. So the crows all flew away, wheeling wildly overhead, round, moving round and round overhead, and cawing, crying loudly. The chickens flapped in circles. Chicken began to move their wings. उनकी wings जो है वो flap करना शुरू कर दिया. Flap करना means that is to move up and down, side to side. जैसे हम हिंदी में जैसे कहते हैं फड़फड़ाना. तो the chickens had begun to flap their wings in circles as if they were being chased. As if it seems like someone chasing them. Now two dogs sitting in the veranda suddenly jumped up and ran out with their tails between their legs. Now let's see that what did these dogs do. So two dogs sitting in the veranda, those who were sitting in the veranda, suddenly jumped up. So as they sense, as the dog sense that something wrong would happen now, they immediately jump up and ran out with their tails between their legs. So they ran fast from there. Within half a minute of her noticing the noise made by the animals, grandmother heard a rattling, rumbling noise. So within half a minute, after these, as grandmother noticed that these animals, these birds are making weird noises and moving around, running round and round. So as she noticed that, afterwards grandmother heard a rattling and rumbling noise. Rattling means like two hard things hitting each other, right? जैसे कि two hard things एक दूसरे को hit करती है तो कैसा sound होता है, right? Like someone knocking continuously, right? And the another example is when train approaches. जब train आती है तो कैसा sound होता है, that's called rattling sound. Rattling sound. So grandmother heard that the rattling and rumbling noise, like the approaches of a train, like the train is approaching that. The noise increased for about a minute, and then there was the first trembling of the ground, and that noise, that rattling and rumbling noise, increased about a minute. All increased ho gaya. And then there was the first trembling of the ground. And then after the first earthquake occurs, the first trembling, first shake occurs of the ground. The animals by this time seemed to have gone mad. And by this time, animals started moving around, and they started making weird noises as if they have gone mad. जैसे वो मैड हो गए, वो दे वर बिहेविंग लाइक दैट. ट्री टॉप्स लश्ड बैकवर्ड्स एंड फॉरवर्ड्स, डोर्स बैंड एंड सीम्ड टू हैव एंड विंडोज शो. सो इवन ट्रीज ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड मूविंग बैक एंड फोर्थ, एंड देन डोर्स बैंड, डोर्स भी बैंग होने लगे, एक दूसरे के साथ हिट होने लगे. And windows shook. Windows started shaking. And grandmother swore later that the house actually swayed in front of her. And then after, grandmother told that actually she saw the house swaying in front of her. जैसे उन्होंने देखा पूरा हाउस उनके सामने, उनकी आंखों के सामने क्या हो रहा था, स्वे मूविंग साइड टू साइड, राइट. सो एक्चुअली शी सॉ दैट स्वे इन फ्रंट ऑफ हर. शी हैड डिफिकल्टी इन स्टैंडिंग स्ट्रेट. शी हैड एक्चुअली डिफिकल्टी टू स्टैंडिंग स्ट्रेट एट दैट टाइम. मीन्स शी कुड नॉट स्टैंड स्ट्रेट एट दैट मोमेंट एट दैट टाइम. Though this could have been due more to the trembling of her knees than to the trembling of the ground. And why did this happen? ये क्यों हुआ? This happened due more to the trembling of her knees. उनके जो knees थे वो ज्यादा tremble कर रहे थे, shake कर रहे थे, more than that the ground. Ground से ज्यादा उनके knees tremble कर रहे थे. That's why she felt difficulty in standing at that moment. Now let's see further what happened. So here means are given, see students, heaviness, that is unpleasant, inclination, that is heat, and sway moved from side to side, that I already explained you, right? Now let's see further what happened. So you can see this picture. She is the grandmother, and see the chickens flap their wings in a circle. Right, flap their wings in a circle. Now let's see. The first shock lasted for about a minute and a half. So the first quack lasted for about a 1 minute and a half. 1.5 minute ke liye first quack aaya. I was in my tub having a bath. Grandfather wrote. For posterity, which for the first time in the last 2 months I had taken in the afternoon instead of in the morning. So, students, try to identify who is I here. I was in my tub having a bath. Who was in the tub and having his bath? So, obviously, grandfather. So grandfather was in tub having his bath. As we have already discussed, the authors many times mentioned that grandfather loved taking his bath, and that's why at the time of time of this quack, he was having his bath. Grandfather wrote for posterity. Grandfather, and this also we have discussed that he actually liked to write things. उनको लिखना, written records रखना अच्छा लगता था, right? So he loved to write things, note करते थे वो सब, and wrote for posterity. For posterity means that is for future generation. And why did he write actually? So for the future generation, for upcoming generation. So for posterity, which for the first time, and even he mentioned that. Which for the first time in the last 2 months, that in the last 2 months this happened first time, that instead of morning he was having his bath in the afternoon, right? Did you get that? That happened first time in last 2 months. Last 2 months mein ye pehli baar hua jab wo bath morning ki jagah pe evening mein le rahe. My wife and children and the Aya were downstairs. So he was upstairs and raised all. They were downstairs. My wife, children, his wife means grandmother, along with the two children and Aya, they were downstairs. Then the shock came, accompanied by loud rumbling sound under the earth and a quacking which increased intensity every second. So then after the shock came, then after the earthquake came, another shock came, accompanied with means together with the loud rumbling sound, the deep loud sound with loud sound under the earth. Jaise koi awaaz earth ke andar se aa rahi ho, itni a rumbling sound, that rumbling sound with that the shock came and a quaking which increased in intensity every second, and the intensity of that quaking, of that earthquake, was increasing every second. Intensity of that earthquake increasing every second. तो उसकी जो intensity है वो every second में ज्यादा हो रही थी, increase हो रही थी. It was like putting measures in a basket and shaking them up with a rapid shifting motion from side to side. So it seemed like that you put something in a box, in a basket, right? And then shake it loudly. So what type of a sound comes? Right? See here it's given. It was like putting many shells in a basket. Ke bahut sare shells ko basket mein rakho. Then shaking them up with a rapid shifting. With the rapidly shifting and motion side to side, and they were moving side to side. And at that time, what type of sound comes? Kaun sa sound aata hai at that time? So that type of feeling the grandfather was at that time, he was assuming that. At first, I did not realize what it was that caused my top to sway about and the water to splash. So in the beginning, first he didn't understand that actually what's weighing my bathtub. Why my bathtub is going side to side, this side and that side. So first in beginning, he did not understand that, and he did not realize that what caused my tub sway about and the water to splash out of the tub. के लिए जो water है वो why it's splashing out of the tub. टब के बाहर क्यों जा रहा है? He didn't realize that. He didn't understand in the beginning first. Okay, I rose up. Then after, anyhow, he managed to get up. वो उठे and found the earth heaving. And that time first intimate him that yes, the earth is heaving. The earth is moving. Why the wash stand, basin, sewer, cups and glasses danced and rocked about in the most hideous fashion, and at that time felt like the wash stand in the bathroom, the wash stand, basin, sewer, that is the drainage, sewer means that is a drainage pipe that we use to drainage the water. So sewer, then the cups, glasses, they all were like dancing and rocking in very hideous way, in a very unpleasant way, in a very unpleasant fashion. Grandfather felt that, right? I rushed to the inner door. I rushed to the inner door. Wait, student. Okay, we reach here. Okay. Finally, we reached. Okay. So he felt like washstand, basin, sewer, cups, glasses, all were dancing in a most hideous fashion. I rushed to the inner door to open it. So he rushed. He rapidly went to the door to open it. कि मैं उसे open कर, bathroom कर, and search for my wife and children. And then after he started searching his wife and children, but could not move the dratted door as boxes, furniture, and plaster had come up against it, but could not move the dratted. Dratted means annoying. जो हमें irritate करे, annoying करे, वो. So the dratted door as boxes, furniture, and plaster had come up against it. So he was unable to open the door because the boxes, the furniture that had fallen against that door. वो door के सामने गिरा था. So he was unable to open it. But could not move the door was only the back door was only the way to escape. Now we had only one way, the back door. Back side में जो door था वो, so the back door was the only way to escape. अब बचने के लिए सिर्फ जो back side का door था वही use करना था उनको. So I managed to burst it open. So with a one burst, he opened it. And thank God and thankfully was able to get out and grandfather was able to come out. So finally he came out. Sections of the thatched roof had slithered down on the four sides like a pack of cards and blocked all the exits and entrance. So the section, jo section of the thatched roof. Thatch means that is a roof made of dried grass and straw. Jo straw, dry grass ko use karke jo roof banai jaati hai na house ki, that is thatch roof. So section of the thatch roof had slithered. Slithered means move slidingly to the ground like a snake. Right? Jaise snake kaise niche aata hai, to waise niche gir jana. So slithered down on the four sides of the house. So all the four sides of the house were blocked by the section of the thatch roof. So sari four sides blocked ho gayi. And blocked all the exits and entrances. And it blocked all the exits and entrance of the house. So puri tarah se block ho gaya. Now let's see. With only a towel wrapped around my waist, I ran out into the open to the front of the house. So with only a towel wrapped around his waist, sirf unhone towel wrap kiya tha unki waist pe, and he ran out into the open to the front of the house. Aur wo open mein unke ghar ke samne front of the house he went there. But found only my wife there, but only grandmother was there. His wife means obviously we are talking about grandmother. So he found only grandmother there. The whole front of the house was blocked by the fallen section of thatch from the roof. And the whole front of the house, ka jo front area hota hai, that was blocked by the fallen section, jo thatch roof ka fallen section tha, usse wo pura house ka entrance block ho gaya tha. So no one can get inside and no one can come outside. Though through this I broke my way under the iron railings, but through this, ye sari difficulties hone ke baad bhi, through this I broke my way, he made his way. Somehow he managed to enter. I broke my way under the iron railings. Iron railings ke under se, and somehow he managed. Unhone kuch bhi karke rasta bana liya. And extricted the others. Extrict karna means to free someone. Okay, and freed others. Baki jo sare wahan pe children and aaya jo the, unko bacha liya. Free, unko free kar diya. The bearer had luckily borne the weight of the whole thatched roof section on his back as it had slithered down, and in this way saved the ayah and the children from being crushed beneath it. So the bearer means here we are talking about all the person, all those who were tolerating the at that time the earthquake. जो वो टाइम पे बैर कर रहे थे, राइट? सो द बैरर हैड लकीली मींस ब्रेवली बोन मींस कैरी करना, कैरी द वेट ऑफ द होल थैच रूफ ऑन सेक्शन ऑन हिज बैक. ये जो बैरर थे सारे हैड लकीली बहुत ही ब्रेवली उन्होंने कैरी किया क्या, द वेट ऑफ द होल थैच रूफ सेक्शन, कि जो पूरा थैच सेक्शन जो गिरा था फॉल हुआ था तो उसका वेट उन्होंने अपने बैक पे लिया. इट स्लिदर्ड डाउन, एज इट स्लिदर्ड डाउन, जो नीचे गिरा था. एंड इन दिस वे सेव्ड द आया एंड द चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम बीइंग क्रश्ड बीनीथ इट. एंड इन दिस वे ही मैनेज्ड टू सेव आया एंड टू चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम बीइंग क्रश्ड बीनीथ द that thatch section of the roof. So today we'll see till here only. Rest part of the chapter we'll see in the next lecture. So hope you have understood it clearly till whatever we have learned till now. Hope you have understood that. And still, if you feel you stuck here and